As a matter of fact, as of today, we are exactly at the halfway point. What that means is that all bills had to be out of their committee of origin by last week. And as of today at 5 o'clock, all bills need to be out of their fiscal committee. What a monumental day for Eastern Washington. It was great to be up there and represent Eastern Washington as the acting president of the Senate. It sends a very strong message to other senators over here on this side of the state that, you know, people from Eastern Washington, we're here to stay, we're here to play, and we can get the job done. It was a great, great day to be up there. Transparency and Permitting Act is a great bill, which again has widespread bipartisan support. You know, I've encountered a lot of small business owners who really ended up getting in trouble, not because they didn't want to comply with the cumbersome rules and regulations, but because they didn't have the time to sit down and try and wade through all those rules and regulations, which oftentimes are duplicative. And so this bill passed off the Senate floor with over 40 votes and is now being sent over to the House. And I just met today with somebody from one of the agencies that would be participating as a requirement of this bill, and they were actually excited that they were going to be required to participate because they also, as an agency representative, they want to make it easier for businesses to do business in this state. One of my most favorite bills that I'm really working hard this session, although I'm not sure we're going to be able to get it all the way done, is my Senate Bill 6515, which is the Reinvest in Washington Act. This is a new way to look at economic development. What I did is I sat down with several different stakeholders back in district and tried to come up with a different way of doing economic development in this state. A lot of what other senators and other representatives like to do is they like to come before the body asking for certain B&O tax exemptions for their pet projects. I myself have done that on occasion, asked for those tax exemptions, and I kept thinking there has to be a better way. There's got to be a better tool we can put in the box, because government should not be in the business of picking winners and losers. And what this bill says is that we take 5 pilot projects, 2 of which have to be in Eastern Washington, and it's with regard to manufacturing and industry, and we say to a manufacturer and in industry, if you invest a certain amount in your company, if you reinvest that amount by way of a capital expenditure or by way of workforce training, then we'll allow you to use what your B&O tax obligation would be to offset the price of that capital expenditure or that workforce training. That bill is going to be heard in Ways and Means in about 45 minutes. And what's been my biggest challenge is educating people that this is a different way to look at economic development. Because as I said, a lot of people look at economic development as just slashing B&O taxes, which I agree, nobody likes B&O taxes. But there has to be another way to give us an additional tool in that box, and that's what 6515 does. I also have another bill, which is for a constituent back home. It's a cider growler bill. And what that bill allows is there are companies that sell beer by the growler, which is a container that people will come into the store with a little screw top on it, and they can get beer filled into these containers and or root beer. And so the growler people would like to have the ability to sell cider, which is an up-and-coming beverage. And Washington State, being the home to all those variety of apples, it just seems like a wonderful natural fit to be able to sell cider in a growler as well. I have a bill that would give a B&O tax preference to businesses that hired the developmentally disabled. And it's not a very big fiscal impact, but it's just, like I like to say, a little something-something to encourage those employers to hire developmentally disabled people. It's so important that those people are allowed to work out in the community. It's great for community members, and it's great for the individual as well. I can tell you unequivocally, not in the Senate. In the House, that is correct. The House voted to give themselves I believe it's a $30 per day increase in their per diem. We are not taking that here in the Senate. No, we are suffering like everybody else across the state has had to suffer because of the resulting economic downturn. You know, we're starting to tick up a little bit, but we're just not at that point where we can go around giving ourselves raises. If you're in Olympia, please stop by my office, even if I'm in committee, because I'm on four committees and we will be returning to committee after we're finished with our floor action over the next couple of weeks. I will make sure that my staff finds where I'm at because it's important to me to have a face-to-face with you. If you've traveled 4.5 hours each way, I want to make sure that we get time to talk about the issue that was so important to bring you over here. And also, if you can't make it over here, please contact me or my office. I'd be happy to meet with you in district, as I often do every time that I'm home.